Hello friends, I Anil Sajnani welcome you to my video lecture. In this video lecture we will be covering singly linked list part 1. We will be learning the basics of the singly linked list, what are the steps of creating singly list, and then finally we will see its implementation in the C compiler with some basic functions. A linked list is a linear data structure in which elements, which are commonly known as nodes, are stored randomly in the memory. They are not in contiguous memory locations like in arrays. Elements of linked list are linked to each other using the pointers. A node is a structure which has two subparts. One is called data and another one is called pointer to the next node, because as I said earlier, these nodes are randomly created in the memory, so there must be something which should connect to each other. So that is why there is a pointer which is a part of the node. So we can show a node like this. Which has two components or two parts. One is data and another one is pointer to the next node. Data can be any C data type. For example, we can include here data like int, data. We can add, say, int array 1 of 10 elements. We can include char name. We can include the array of char, that is char pointer name. So we can include any data type in the data part. Since a node is created randomly in the heap or memory, linking among them necessary. This linking is provided by the second part of the node, that is the pointer, as I explained earlier. Now let us consider a linked list of three nodes which can be represented like this. Node 1. We may call it first. Second node. Then there will be a third node. Now, in the first node, the data we can put as 10. In the second, the data can be 20. In the third, data can be 30. The pointer of the first, normally we call it next, will carry the address of the second. That means the address of the second will be fed here so that it will link to the second node. Similarly, the next of the second will carry the address of the third so that it will point to the third node. The next of the third, which is the last node, will carry null to show that this is the last node. Since we are dealing with pointers in the list, each part of the node will be represented as this will show the data of the first, which we have assigned a value 10. Similarly, the data of the second will be assigned the value like this. And so on. Similarly, if we have to represent the pointer of the first, we will say the next of the first is equivalent to second, and the next of the second, that is this one, will be assigned the address of the third one, and so on. We will keep on assigning the values like this. The structure of the node can be defined like this. This is the name of the structure. We can assign any name. I am using SList. So here you can mention the data. So to make it simple, let us declare one data into this, which is an integer type. And always in the list, you have to define the pointer for the next node, which you will define as struct SList type next. So this is how you will define the structure of a node. Now this data you can add as many datas as you want. So this will become a structure which is a user defined, and the structure data type is struct SList. Now we will talk about the declaration of variables of the structure type defined above. We will declare pointers of this structure type like this. Struct SList type, because this is a data type, like you declare a variable of int type, char type, float type. Similarly, now we are declaring a variable of this structure type, that is struct SList. And then we will give the name of the variable. Here in list, we declare normally the pointers. So I will say star first. We can declare star second. And star third. So now I have declared three variable pointers of type struct SList. If you have to refer this structure each time, you have to write struct SList, because this is a default data type. Now we can redefine this data type, that is struct SList, with one word, say node. Let us see how this can be done. For this we will use the keyword type def. So now, in spite of defining a structure like this, I will define it like this. I will say type def struct SList, and then you will define the structure int data, then struct SList type next. And now here you will define a single word how you want to represent the struct SList, or which name you want to give to the struct SList data type. Let us give the name node. So now, in spite of referring this structure every time by struct SList, we can refer it simply by saying the node. This is the advantage of using the keyword type def. So that means now we can declare our variables of pointer type like this: node type first, second, and third. So now I have declared three pointers which are of data type node. Now let us create the node first, second, and third by using the statement: first is equal to node star malloc size of node. Now in this statement we have created a node whose name is first, which is of the type node, and we have allocated a dynamic memory by using the keyword malloc, and this the size of this memory is equivalent to the size of the node. This is what we mean by this statement. Similarly, we can create other nodes like second, third by running the same statement. If we have not used the keyword type def, then the statement should look like this: first is equal to, you will give the data type, that is struct as list. So you are creating a node of type struct as list star, and you will be allocating the memory dynamically by using malloc whose size should be equivalent to the struct as list. Now these two statements are doing the same job, except that we have replaced struct as list by the word node because we have used type def in defining the structure. Once the nodes are created like this, then we need to assign them the values. So how can we assign the values to these? Simply, as I showed you earlier, we will say the data of the first, because it is an integer type, we assign a value 10. Similarly, the data of the second, we may assign a value 20. Similarly, the data of the third will be assigned a value 30. So once the values are assigned, so that means up till now what we have created three nodes by the name of first, and you have assigned the data value 10. Then you have created a second node and you have assigned a value 20 to this. You have created a third node and you assigned a value 30 to this node by the name of third. These are randomly created in the memory, so they are not forming a list as such up till now. They are not connected to each other. Now the thing left is, how do we connect first, second, and third to create a list? That is done by assigning the address of second to the next of the first. Similarly, the address of the third node will be assigned to the next of the second. Okay, so now let us see how that will be done. So simply we will say that the next of the first, because this pointer is represented by next as per our data structure, so we will say the next of the first and you are assigning the address of the second, because all these are pointers. So when you say the next of the first and you assign second, so that means now this address will be linked with this. So these two nodes, first and second, are linked to each other. Similarly, we will link third with the second by saying next of the second is third. So by writing this statement, you have assigned the address of third node to the second. So now these are attached to each other, and always remember, the last node must be assigned the value null. So we will say third next is equivalent to null. This is because if we want to traverse in the list, we will traverse from first till it reaches to the value null. Now since this list is only traversable in forward direction from first to third, this is called a singly linked list, because you can traverse only in a single direction, in a forward direction. So it is called singly linked list. Now let us create this list in a C compiler and see the results. So now here we are seeing the program in the compiler. It is absolutely the same program which I explained you earlier. Here we are using the same structure as list with type def, and the data type name we have mentioned is node. So we need not have to refer struct as list every time. Now we can replace it by simply node. In the main program, you can see we have declared four pointers of the type node by the name of first, second, third, and a extra one p, which I explain you why I have taken this. Now after clear screen, we have created the nodes as I explained you earlier, first, second, and third. So now these three nodes are created in the memory. After this, we have assigned data to first, second, and third as 10, 20, and 30 in the data field of the structure. We are assigning pointers to the next node so that we can create a list. That is shown here. You can see in this program, you can see next of the first is given the address of the second, to the second the address of the third is assigned, third being the last one is assigned null. As I explained earlier, the last node will have a value null. Now let us see how to traverse in the list. Now the list which we have created in our program is like this: first, second, and third with the values 10, 20, and 30, and the last one has a value null. In order to traverse in the list and read the values, what we will be doing is we will be running a loop. Now within the loop, first we will read the value of the node. So how we can read the value of the node? We will say printf data of the first. When the data of the first, that means 10 is red. After this, we will say go to the next node. For this, we will say first is equal to first ka next. That means when I say first is equal to next of the first, that means now second, because first ka next is second, because this is the next. So first ka next is second. So now this has become first. So when this has become first, under the loop it will read the value of first. So now it will read the value 20, and then in the loop it will say first is equal to next of the first. Now what is the next of the first now, because now second has become first, so its next will be third. So that means now third has become first. So when third has become first, it will read the value of the first again. So that means 30 is read. After that it will say first is equal to first ka next. Now what is first ka next? That is null. So we will run this loop till the first reaches to the null. This is how we can read the data and we can move to the next element in the list. But here you will see there is a problem. The problem is that the identity of the first is gone. Once I run this loop, then the second will become first and then the third will become first. So I have no identity of this node and this node. First node and second node's identity is gone. So this is a wrong procedure. Then in that case, what to do? Now in order to solve this problem, we will take an additional pointer. For this I will say node star p. Like we have first, second and third pointers of type node, similarly p is also a pointer of type node. After this I will give this p name to the first in addition. So that means I will say p is equal to first. When I say p is equal to first, now this node, the first node, has two names, first and p. So now I will traverse with the help of p, not using the first. I will use only p so that the identity of the first will remain as it is. So with this, now we will say under the loop read the p's data and then go to the next node with the help of p is equal to next of p. So in this way, now second will become p, it will read the data of p, then it will go to the next of p. When this is p, the next of p is now third. So it will read the value of third, and then it will say it will go to the next of p, which is null, and where this loop will stop. So what is important to understand here is, in order to maintain the identity of the first node, you will use an additional pointer. You can name it anything. I am using p because I have mentioned in the program as p, and then I will say p is equal to first, so that my first node has two names, first and p. Then I will work with p without disturbing the name first. So now let us go back to the compiler and see how to traverse in the list. So now you can see here we have already taken a pointer p for this purpose, which I told you I will tell you later. So now I think it is clear to all of you why we have taken an additional pointer. So now with the help of this pointer I will traverse in the list. So now here, as I explained you, I will say p is equal to first. So now first has two names, p and first, and now I will run a loop with the help of p. So I will say while p is not equal to null, the loop will run before the p goes to null. Now under this loop we will read the data of p. So I will say printf in the next line integer value of data of p. So this is how you will mention this. So now in this way you can read the data of p. After reading the data of p, now we have to move to the next node. So I will switch over to next node by saying p is equal to next of p. So in this way we will keep on jumping till p reaches to null. And now I close this. This is all we have to do for the traversing in the list. So if I run this program now, you will see that it will read the values 10, 20 and 30. So here we are, you are seeing the values 10, 20 and 30. Now here there is again one question. If I want to add another node, how can I add the node? Let us say I want to add a node fourth. How can I add this node? For this again I will create a node here. I will create a node fourth here. I will add the value of fourth and then I will do some manipulation here. Now what manipulation is required? I will show you. Now here you are seeing that we are already having first, second and third with the values 10, 20 and 30. Now I want to add fourth node. The value is 40. Now in the existing list we have third pointing to the null. Now after adding fourth one we will have to point fourth one to the null and the fourth address is given to the third. Now how will we do it? So what we will do, we will simply say the next of the fourth is equal to null. So this will be pointing to null and this null will be replaced by the fourth. Now the third will be modified. Now the next of the third will be modified to fourth and fourth next will become null. So this is how we will add a fourth element. So now I will go back to the compiler and I will show you how to add this fourth one. So first I will add a fourth node here. Fourth is equal to node star malloc size of node. So I have added a fourth node. Next I will add the value in the data field of the fourth one. So I will say data of fourth is equal to 40. Now before this I must declare the fourth pointer also here. So here before p now I am adding star fourth. So now fourth is added. So now we will do the modification in the pointers. So you can see here the third one is null. So now I will point this third one to the fourth. So I will say here fourth. So the third one is modified and we have to add fourth ka next is equal to null. So this is all we have to do, and a new node is added into this. So there is no change in the traversal side. So now let us run this program and see whether it gives you 10, 20, 30 and 40. So let us run this. Here you are, you can see 10, 20, 30 and 40 is shown. So this is a simple program which shows you how to create a simple list, a singly list within the main function with few elements known to you, and how to traverse in the list. Here again, one observation is you have four elements 1, 2, 3, 4. So you have named them 1, 2, 3 and 4th. What happened if you have more than 100 elements in the list? How will you do it? Now I could enter the fourth element because I knew third is the last one. Okay, so I modified the next entry of the third from null to fourth, and fourth is made null. What about if we have more than 100 nodes? We do not know what are the names of these nodes. Normally they don't have, we call them simply a node. There is no name of these nodes. Then how will you add a element at the end when you don't know which is the last node at present? This is what I will be discussing in my next video of the singly list part 2, where we will create a list with many functions, inserting nodes at various locations, in the beginning, in the end, at some particular location, deleting the nodes at various locations again. So in order to continue learning singly list, please watch my part 2 video. Thank you for watching this video.